There we go, Mr. Joe Posada. En aquel baile te conocí, en aquel baile I had to go pee pee and all that other good stuff. Good morning, Double R Radio. Bam, 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 bam. Tuesday morning. Anyways, 8:05 por la mañana, August the 6th, 2019. I don't know why my phone was saying I didn't have Wi-Fi. What the hell? I paid for my Wi-Fi, man. It's saying, hey, Robert, you don't have no Wi-Fi. Go pay your bill. I paid my bill. Pinche Spectrum cabrones. Right. All pissed off right away on a Tuesday morning, right? Good morning, child. I'm going to have to Double R Radio sponsor, Mr. James Gonzalez. Mr. Money Mart himself. That's right, Money Mart Pond. You can check him out in Houston, in San Antonio, in Africa, in Jamaica. They're all over the place. Isn't it? Pinche Money Mart, they're all over the place. Hey, wow. Good morning, child. I'm going to have to... Let's see here. It's not cousin. It's my niece. There we go. Katie Lee Denny. Say, Katie Lee, where are you checking me out from, Katie? I'm very interested. Where are you? Because Katie does a lot of traveling. Katie does a whole lot of traveling. She really, really does. I'm not talking like a basketball player traveling. I'm talking like a tourist kind of traveling. Katie Lee does. She really, really does. Good morning, Katie. There we go. Anyway, Tuesday morning it is. Buenos dias. My birthday week. Actually, I'll be celebrating my birthday Saturday. I'll be turning the big 5'9". Yeah, 5'9". The big 59. I can't believe that, man. 59 years old. Heck, man, my grandbaby Mia tells me, Grandpa, you're an old fart. I said, mira, mamita, what a cool. Anyways, I'm not playing either. You think I'm playing? Anyways, yesterday... Actually, this happened Sunday. I was in downtown San Antonio. Good morning, shout out. That's Heather Benson. Good morning. Yesterday, I was in downtown, Sunday, I was in downtown San Antonio, and I was at a red light right by the Alamo, right? I had a passenger in the back seat, and there was this raspa vendor to my left. So I'm here at the light waiting, right? And I'm looking at the raspa vendor. They were right next to me. I'm looking at them, and there's a guy and a girl. They're sitting there, and I'm looking at them, and I'm going, I wonder how much they're selling those raspas for. Just out of curiosity, how much are they selling snow cones for, right? Good morning, shout out to Double R Radio sponsor Cynthia Gonzalez Ramirez. Buenos dias, Robert. There we go. Katie Lee Denny says, just at work in a meeting. You're making it fun. Live in the morning. There you go, Katie. There we go. Good morning. So anyways, I asked the raspa vendor, the snow cone vendor. I lowered my window and said, hey, how much is it for a snow cone? They told me, $5. And I go, $5 for a snow cone? Are you serious? Five? I said, does that come with bourbon or rum or, you know, some tequila? She goes, no, only the snow cone, $5. I said, man, you're expensive. And then you got beat up tennis shoes, tore up blue jeans. You haven't even combed yourself or anything, but yet you're selling raspas for $5. Talk about taking advantage of tourists, right? Good morning, shout out to Double R Radio sponsor Deborah Camarillo, Anaheim, California, in the casa. Good morning, good morning, good morning. So anyway, there you go, man. If you're going to downtown San Antonio and you feel it's really super hot outside and you need a raspa, be prepared to pay $5 because that's what they're charging. Crazy, right? Now, yesterday evening, I hadn't eaten breakfast. I didn't eat lunch, so it was around 6:30 in the afternoon. I was starving. This is all true. And I passed by a Blanco Cafe. If you live in San Antonio, you know what Blanco Cafes are all about. Well, I passed by a Blanco Cafe, and I said, I'm going to go eat, man. Papa, I'm hungry. So I went to the Blanco Cafe, right? Check this out. They got this plate called the Mexican Deluxe. I used to know a girl who had the same plate, but we're not going to go there right now. This is a family show. And boy, what a deluxe plate she had. But we're not going to go there. This is a family show. So so anyway, the waitress comes and she goes, what would you like to order? Do you need a menu? And I said, I already know what I want. Get me that Mexican deluxe plate. Now, just in case you don't know what's on it, here's what you get. For an appetizer, you get a chalupa, a crispy taco, and a side of guacamole. That's your appetizer. Then they bring on the main course. 3 enchiladas, rice, beans, 2 tortillas. Man, I'm serious, man. I was tearing that baby up, man. I was eating it, and while I was eating it, I was going, man, this is better than sex. And I would eat some more. But I caught myself talking out loud. I was saying, this is better than sex. And I was eating some more, got the tortilla, guacamole. And I was like, this is better than sex. And the people around me were going, man, this guy must be a lonely guy. He seems to think that those enchiladas are better than sex. I said, sorry, I'm just enjoying this plate. Really, man, if you've never tried it, try it. Go to Blanco Cafe, man. I'm giving them a big plug here. Blanco Cafe on Fredericksburg Road, man. They got this monster plate called the Mexican Deluxe Plate. Bam! It is better than sex. Good morning, John. Good afternoon, Tony Gloria Guerrero the Third. There we go. Austin, Texas in the casa. Anyways, Tuesday morning it is. Now, I want to talk about this. I'm going to get serious here for just a minute. I don't want to run out of time here, but I do want to talk about this. I stumbled across a story about 20 minutes ago, and I do want to talk about this. Check this out. The Quintanilla family. The Quintanilla family has threatened to file a lawsuit against an event organizer who is located in Corpus Christi, Texas. To my knowledge, the way I'm seeing everything here, I'm only reading it as I see it. And they built a mural on the wall with images of Selena. That's all good. That's all fine and dandy. You know, I know Abraham Quintanilla. I'm not saying I know him upside down, but I know him. We've worked together. I consider him a friend. I think he considers me one too. We'll talk once in a while. We'll get together for a taco. Okay, so you with me so far? All that being said, this event that was going to be doing some kind of a neighborhood event in Corpus Christi, Texas, which would have been in the same neighborhood where Selena was just raised, born and raised there in Corpus. Well, anyways, this event coordinator was going to be profiting from this kind of event that he was going to be having to unveil this mural of Selena. Now, let me just say this. You're probably going, Robert, well, why is he threatening to sue this event coordinator? And I'm going to tell you why. The reason he was looking to sue or looking to stop this event was because this event organizer, coordinator, was seeking to profit from this event using his daughter's image. Now, a lot of people get pissed off at this. They say, hey, what's up with him, this and that. Now, let me just say this. I'm not defending Abraham Quintanilla. He doesn't need no defending, I promise you. He does not need no defending whatsoever. The deal is here is that what he doesn't like is when somebody is profiting off of his daughter. And you're probably going, well, the guy's got millions and millions of dollars. You know, hey, that's beside the point. You know, if somebody is profiting off of you, your kids, your husband, your wife, your image, your songs, you probably wouldn't like it either. But like I said, I can remember, and I'm gonna share this with you guys. This is all true. Okay, I've done many, many things in my life, Tejano-wise, event-wise, club-wise. This is all true. When I used to DJ at T-Town, and listen up, this is a true story. When I used to DJ at T-Town, one night, Selena performed at T-Town. The night was over. Okay, the night was over. Now, at the backside of the club, there was a lot of people. And I said, what's going on to the side? And Selena happened to be out there. And she was signing autographs. All true. This photographer that would go into a, you know, the club and take pictures. Remember the Polaroid picture? They take a picture, the Polaroid would come out. Well, he happened to be there. And what was going on, see, I got time. What was going on was this person taking pictures with the Polaroid. You know, the let's just say you're right there. You'd get next to Selena, the guy with the Polaroid would take your picture. He'd get it. Next. And psst. Next, and people were and taking pictures and getting the Polaroids waiting for them to dry, right? So you could see your image. Well, all was fine and dandy. And out of left field, Abraham shows up. And he goes, what's going on here? And I told him, they're taking pictures with Selena. And Abraham asked me, is he making money from this? And I said, I don't know. So he went up to the photographer and told the photographer, hey you. Are you charging these people for these pictures? And the guy tells him, I've got to make a living. And Abraham looked at him and said, not off of my daughter. So he stopped everything right there. And he told all the people, don't pay this guy. Do not pay him. Okay, don't pay them. If you want to take a picture with my daughter for free, great, no problem. But if we got a guy here charging you to take pictures with Selena, my daughter, I don't think so. And that was the end of the party. I remember Selena getting all nervous. She told me, Robert, what's going on? I said, your dad's pissed off because that guy over there is charging to take pictures of you with your fans. She goes, oh, but I'll never forget. Selena looked very, very nervous, very, very, like, wow, man, her dad really, man. When he starts yelling and screaming, he'll make people nervous. He really, really will. And that's a true story. It really, really is. So getting back to that little neighborhood deal, it doesn't surprise me. I remember having a conversation with Abraham and him telling me that they would catch people selling Selena t-shirts, Selena stuff, souvenirs or whatever, and they'd stop them. They'd stop them. But he goes, but as soon as you stop one or two, five or six more come out. He goes, it's never ending. We can keep on trying to stop them, but it's never ending. People keep on selling Selena merchandise out there, illegally, of course. And he goes, but if we catch one or two vendors, seven or more pop up over here. He said, it's never ending. So I can respect what the man is doing. He's stopping a person from profiting from using his daughter's images. I can respect that. I really, really can. And even more so in his own backyard. Hey, man, worst comes to worst, if I would have been that organizer, I would have gone to Abraham and asked his permission. Hey, dude, I've got this going on. Do you think it's possible that we can do this or that? And take it from there. You know what I mean? Do it the right way. Good morning, shout out to Hilda Muniz Hernandez. Good morning. Tuesday morning it is. Anyways, people have been telling me, Robert, so how old are you going to be Saturday, Robert? 59 years old. And mind you, I'm in denial. I still got my Farrah Fawcett t-shirt. I still got my bell-bottom pants and my Saturday Night Fever stuff, right? But, back in the box somewhere back there, right? Still living the disco days. Anyway, speaking of Selena, let's do it. Let me play one of my favorite Selena songs. Good morning, Double R Radio. There we go. Let's get back to the morning show. Join me, RobertRevisRadio.com. It's that simple. RobertRevisRadio.com. Just click on that play button, man, and you'll be joining me live. It's all free. What are they? Join me now.